Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Electronics Hacker. This is Kaushal Maurya and I hope you are very well, safe and sound. So friends, in this video we have talked about the capacitors, capacitance and such important definitions related to the capacitors. So let's start with the capacitor. So the capacitor is an electronic component. In the previous lecture we have known about the capacitor, inductor and resistor. These are three are the passive component. So here is the capacitor. It is an electronic component that stores electric charge. Capacitor stores the electric charge and it is also in a passive component. Next is the capacitor is the storage element which we can store and deliver energy in the electric field. So capacitor is a storage element. Basically it is a storage element which is we can store and deliver energy in the form of the electric field. And a typical capacitor is shown in the figure. Capacitor made of the two or more close conductors. Close conductor means usually dielectrics or plates which is shown in the figure. It is the positive charged plate and it is the negative charged plate which are not connected or touching each other. They are separated with the dielectric materials and not touching each other but are electrically separated either by the air or by the some form of the good insulating material such as the waxed paper, mica, ceramic, plastic or the some form of the liquid gel as used to the electrolyte capacitors as on the figure. In the capacitors between their plates we are not using any conducting things. We are only using insulating materials or the air. We also know that the air is the bad conductor of electricity. So it is also the insulator. So in the between the plates of the capacitor we are only used the air or the insulating materials such as the waxed paper, mica, ceramic, plastic or the some form of the liquid gel are used in the electrolyte capacitors. So the insulating layer between the capacitor plate is commonly called the dielectric. It is noted that the insulating material, the insulating layer between the capacitor plate are commonly called the dielectric. What is called? Dielectric. So this is the typical capacitor shown in the figure and this is the typical capacitor with the parallel plates. Symbol of the capacitor are shown in the figure and the electric charges of two plates. It is the plus Q here and minus Q is here and the conducting parallel plates are faced opposed to each other and dielectric in between them and it is connected with the voltage, any voltage VC. So next is the any two metal plates between which an electric field can be maintained constitute a capacitor. It is noted that the any two metal plates between which the electric field can be maintained, so it's constitute a capacitor. It is not can be generated. It is always we know at that any two metal plates between which have the electric field, so it's constituted as a capacitor. Next point is that the plates accumulate electric charge. Plates accumulate electric charge when connected to the power source. It is noted that it is only accumulated electric charge when it will be connected with the power source. And one plate accumulates positive charge and other plate accumulates negative charge. As we see in the figure, one have the minus Q charge and one have the positive Q charge. So it says that the one plate accumulates positive charge and the other plates accumulates negative charge. Next point is that the capacitance is the amount of the electric charge. Capacitance, here we talk about the capacitance which is the amount of the electric charge that is stored in the capacitor. So capacitor is a component in which the capacitance is stored in the form of the electric charge and at a voltage of the 1 volt, the capacitance is measured in the unit of farad. Farad is a unit of measuring the capacitance, and at the voltage of 1 volt, the capacitance in the measured in the unit of the farad. Next point is says that the capacitor is only not only used for the storage of the electricity, for the blocking DC. We all know that it is not only used for the storage electricity, but it is also used for the blocking the DC. Also used for applications such as the filtering of electrical signal. Previously we have talked about the filters. So there we are also talk about the capacitor used in the filter for the blocking the electrical signal. Tuning circuits. Tuning means the set of range of frequency range of any component or device. So it is also used, capacitor is also used in the tuning, coupling and decoupling. So these are the applications of the capacitor. So it can be noted that capacitor is not only used for the storage electricity, but it have the many applications. So next point is that there are the many different kinds of capacitors available in the market, and for the very small capacitor beats used in the resonance circuit to large power factor correction capacitors, but they all do the same things, they are store charge. So basic work of the capacitor is the store charge, but it have the many applications. So next talk about the capacitance, which is the unit of the capacitor. So capacitance, the property of the capacitor to store charge on its plates in the form of electrostatic field are called the capacitance of the capacitor. So capacitance is the property of capacitor to store the electric charge on the plates in the form of electrostatic field. So it is known as the capacitance. And capacitance is the property of the capacitor to store the electric charge when its plates are at the different potential. We know that one have the potential of the plus Q and one have the minus Q. So if the Q coulomb of charge is given to the one plate of the capacitor and a potential difference of V volt is applied between the two plates, then the capacitance between the plates, capacitance between the two plates are the C is equal to Q upon V, where the Q is the coulomb, that is the charge given on the plates, and V is the voltage applied between them. So it is calculated that the C is equal to Q upon V. And the capacitance is an electrical property of the capacitor, and it is measure of the capacitor's ability to store the electric charge onto its two plates, with the unit of capacitance being the farad, abbreviated it is seen on the capital F. And next point is that the value of the capacitance is depend upon the main factor of these factors. So the value of the capacitance are depended upon some factors. So just take a look on these factors. First factor is the surface area. The surface area, it is commonly denoted by the capital A of the two conducting plate which make up the capacitor. The larger area, greater capacitance. The lesser area, low capacitance. So it is directly proportional to the surface area. Capacitance is the depend on the factor of the surface area, that the more surface area, more capacitance, less surface area, less capacitance. Second is the distance. Distance is commonly denoted as the small d, and distance means between the distance between the two plates of the capacitors, and the smaller of the distance is the greater capacitance, and the greater of the distance have the smaller capacitance. Because of the difference between the two plates, that is the two potential differences, can be decreases the capacitance between them. And third factor is the dielectric material, the type of the material which separates the two plates called the dielectric. And we further studied that the dielectric material are used, then that is the mica, ceramic and etc. So the higher of the permittivity of the dielectric is the greater of the capacitance, and the lower of the permittivity have the lower capacitance between the capacitor or the capacitor. So next is a note, some notes, 2 points. A capacitor is said to have the capacitance of the 1 farad of charge on the 1 coulomb is required to stabilize the potential difference between the 1 volt between the plates. It means when we have to generate the 1 farad capacitance, so we require to the 1 coulomb of the 1 coulomb of the potential difference and the 1 coulomb of the charge and the 1 volt of the potential difference between the plates. So we have to apply the 1 volt battery between them, as we shown in the figure, and the capacitance, which is commonly called capital C, is always positive and has no negative units. So it can be noted, and it is noted that the capacitance, which is denoted as the capital C, is always have the positive and it has no negative unit. For the capacitor, the current through the through it is proportional to the rate of the change of the voltage across it. So current through it passes is directly proportional. To the voltage applied to the voltage applied across through it. So next topic is the voltage equation of the capacitor. We have talked about the voltage equation of the capacitor, as we will know as that the Q is equal to CV. Small q is equal to CV and I is equal to dQ by dt. There will be the small change of charge are known as the current. So change in the dQ by dt is denoted by the I, and here we further Q is equal to CV, then we can interchange by the Q from the CV, then d by dt CV is equal to C constant, so C is the rest, and C dV by dt. So dV is equal to 1 upon C I dt. Next is the integrating both side in this equation. C is equal to, dV is equal to 1 upon C dt, integrating both side and taking limit potential between V0 to V, Vt. And here the integrating V0 integration to the Vt dV is equal to 1 upon C is the constant, integral 0 to V I dt. So here we got Vt is equal to 1 upon C integral 0 to T I dt plus V0. The quantity of V0, that is denotes the initial voltage across the capacitor. When there is the no initial voltage applied on the capacitor, when we have no voltage applied on the capacitor at the initial stage, so it is denoted that the V0. This things. And the final equation is the Vt is equal to 1 upon C integral 0 to T I dt. It is the voltage equation for the capacitance. So next topic is the energy stored in the capacitor. So let's consider the capacitance C farad be charged from a source of V volt. Then the current I is given by the I is equal to C dV by dt. No problem. Then the energy supplied to the capacitor during the interval of dt is given by the dW is equal to V dot I dot dt. No problem. dt is equal to P dot C dV by dt into dt. So dt and dt is the cancel out, and hence the total energy supplied to the capacitor when potential difference between is increased from the 0 to the V volt, 0 to the V volt to the charging of the source from the initial to the I current. So the final equation found, the E is equal to the integral 0 to V C dot V dot dV is equal to 1 upon 2 CV square. Half CV square. So this is the final equation for the energy stored in the capacitor. We'll find. Next topic is the advantage of the dielectric materials. So what is the advantage of the dielectric material? Why we can only use the dielectric material between the capacitor plates, two capacitor plates? Why we are not using the conducting material or the other things? Why we are using the dielectric material? So here the advantage of the dielectric material. The dielectric constant is the property of the dielectric material, and varies from the one material to another, increasing the capacitance by the factor of k. It is increases when the material to another increasing the capacitance by a factor of the small k. Second point, the dielectric provides the mechanical support. It is noted that the dielectric provides that the mechanical support between the two plates, allowing the plates to be the closer together without touching. We also know that the two plates are not touchable, not in the electrical connection. So the dielectric gives him the mechanical support between the two plates. Next point is the permittivity of the dielectric increases the capacitance. We all know as capacitance will be increased by the permittivity of the dielectric. And third point is the dielectric increases when the maximum operating voltage compared to the air. So in the comparison to the air, why we can measurely use to the air is also used, but majorly we are used to the dielectric because of the dielectric have the maximum operating voltage compared to the air. Next point is the conductance. So it is the recent word that the conductance is the term of the conductance was introduced by the German scientist Werner von Siemens. Werner von Siemens introduced the word conductance, term conductance, and conductance is the reciprocal of resistance. So it is denoted by the capital G, and the expression for the conductance is written by the G is equal to 1 by R. So we also know about the R is equal to rho L by A. So it is the reciprocal. So 1 by R is equal to 1 A upon rho L. So we can say that the G is equal to rho A by L, sigma A by L, where the sigma is called the conductivity, R specific conductance of the material, and the unit of the conductance is the mho, or the Siemens. Siemens are the mho, but in the unit of conductance is frequently represented by the mho, which is the reciprocal of the ohm, and it is denoted in the symbol. So at last we have talked about the voltage and current relationship. Last but not least, voltage and current relationship, the relationship between the potential difference across the passive element and the current through them are the given in the table. So first here the serial number, passive element, relationship and symbolic circuits. So first is the resistor. So resistors relationship, voltage and current are the V is equal to IR. That's the symbolic circuit are the R and the plus I and minus I and voltage between them are so. Next is the inductor, and V is equal to L di by dt, and it inductor shows the inductor circuit, simple circuits are shown in the figure. And third is the capacitor which is I is equal to C dv by dt, and symbol are the shown in the figure. So resistor dissipates energy in the form of heat, inductor stores the energy in the form of magnetic field, and the capacitor stores the energy in the form of electric field. If someone asks you that what is the basic difference of the resistor, inductor, capacitor, then you tell these three are the passive component, but the resistor dissipates energy in the form of heat, inductor stores the energy in the form of magnetic field, and capacitor stores in the energy in the form of electric field. The voltage and current, the case of resistor, are in phase, whereas the case of the inductor current lags. It is noted that the voltage and current in case of current resistor are in the phase, same phase, no phase difference. And in case of inductor, current lag and voltage leads. Current lags, voltage leads, means current lags and voltage leads by the 90 degree. Lag lead concept are given by the next lecture. So, and in the case of the capacitor, the current leads and the voltage lags. Current leads, voltage leads, reciprocal of the inductor condition. So the heat produces by the resistor are shown in the some equations are shown here. So heat produces by the resistor is H is equal to I square RT, and heat produced in the form of joule, where the I is equal to RMS value of current in ampere and R is equal to resistance in the ohms and T is equal to time of the second. So here is the equation for the heat produced by the resistor is H is equal to I square RT in the form of joule. Heat, the SI unit of the heat is the joule. And next is the energy stored in the inductor is equal to E is equal to 1 upon 2 Li square and it is also in the joule. And where the L is the inductance in farad and energy stored in the capacitor is the E is equal to half CV square joules, where the V is equal to voltage across the capacitor in volt and C is equal to capacitance in the farad. So conversion of joule in the calorie, it is noted that the 1 calorie is equal to the 4.18 joule. So here friends, in this video we have talked about the capacitor, capacitance, conductance, advantage of dielectric material and certain extra things which is important for the electronics components and devices and the analog electronics, which is very important for the basic electronic systems. So guys, thanks for watching for video. Thank you very much.